Namaste, Suprabhatam, Shubhasayam for all those who have joined us on the 34th day of the Global Festival of Yoga, being brought to you by Indica Yoga and all its organizing partners. The Indica Yoga as a platform, as you're all familiar, offers diverse and inclusive forms of yoga, which is authentic, immersive and transformative in nature. And when we are speaking about the inclusive and diverse forms, we have kept in our mind to see that yoga encompasses every walk of life, not to be left out anything, not to leave out anything. So in this backdrop, we have looked into how walking can be yoga, how talking can be yoga, how singing can be yoga. Yesterday, we also saw how Leading to sleep can be yoga, and this morning we will be exploring how having fun, games can be an expression of yoga. And this session will be led by none other than our dear friend, Shri Subbu Bhaiya. I request Subbu ji to kindly come on the screen. Namaste, Subbu ji. Swagatam.
Swagatam, namaste.
So you all are already familiar with Subbu ji. He has been with us from the beginning of the festival. He has been one of the most dynamic, charismatic anchors we have had. And today he is with us as a presenter. And just to give you a very brief formal introduction to Subbu ji or dear Subbu Bhaiya, Shri Subbu Bhaiya, or his actual name is Dr. Subramaniam Ananda Venkata, is currently the director of Adhyatma Yoga Academy at Bangalore. He gave up his engineering profession to take up full-time spiritual sadhana since 2004. He has his master's degree in yoga from Yes Vyasa and doctoral study on yogic contributions of spiritual masters of the Bhakti movement from Hindu University of America, Florida. Subbu Bhaiya is a disciple of Swami Atma Samsthananda Ji Maharaj of Ramakrishna Order and Mahatma Krishna Premi Maharaj in the Bhakti tradition. You might remember we had Sri Rangan Ji who had come here to take a session on Ramayana and Yoga. And Rangan Ji is the son of Mahatma Krishna Premi Swami Ji. And Subbu Ji is also one of the closest proteges of Padma Shri Dr. H.R. Nagendra Guruji. So he has been fortunate to work closely with many such masters. We just had three names here, but maybe during the course of his presentations, he might be able to share with you that of all many youngsters, he is really one who is fortunate to have been closely, whether it is Swami Dayananda Saraswati Ji or whether Atma Samsthananda Ji Maharaj or many other such masters, he has had the opportunity to serve them closely, work with them closely, and to be guided by them in a very close manner. And he has also been widely traveling, inspiring and guiding people on the path through workshops, retreats and yatras. He has trained thousands of yoga teachers and is part of various academic bodies and universities connected to yoga. Many of us in Bangalore or even elsewhere know him as Apad Bandhava. So whenever there's a requirement, you just knock at his door and there you will have Subbu Bhaiya. So even as he's involved in this program, during this program also, he had to address many such calls. So he used to go and just come back, be present for the sessions. So that's how many yoga teachers, many aspiring yoga teachers, many aspiring institution builders look up to him for his help, guide and support. And that he does with a very generous heart. And Subbuji's, there are many initiatives that Subbuji has undertaken. And one among them is Yoga Mitra, which is a collective platform for yoga teachers to involve social works. So he has started this platform where yoga teachers dedicate their time to social causes. So wherever there's a requirement of a yoga teacher, maybe in a hospital or a health home or an old age home. So all these yoga volunteers, they go in and offer their teaching and support, volunteering completely free of cost. And that is an initiative by Subbu ji. And he also recently started a very popular talk show called Kapi with Yogi. And even the word Kapi is a very interesting word. He will be explaining it in a little while. So that is a series where he invited many senior sadhaks or achievers of the yoga field and had a very detailed interview bringing out many facets of their lives which was unknown to most of us. So in that way, that was a very popular series, and on demand, he is extending that series which will continue every month from now onwards. So with these words, I am very happy to welcome Subbu ji once again. Swagatam, Subbu ji.
Namaste.
And we also have a few of his team members who will be joining us for this session. to demonstrate and to participate in all that he will be leading us through. I request Subhuji to kindly introduce them and also introduce us this session. What is this Kriya Yoga and how do you plan to go about?
Thank you, Vinayji, for this nice introduction. It is in my mother tongue, Tamil, we have a saying, you know, Purandatha Perumiya Vadaparandanta Klavinala. Like you telling the, you know, glory of your maternal house to your own brother. You know, a lady glorifying her maternal house glories to her own brother. So it's like that. So I'm part of the Indica Yoga family. And also all the participants who have been attending, now it's almost more than 30 days. So all the participants are our own family members, our own yoga bandhavaha. So that way, you know, we feel the connection. And that's where, you know, I thought today we will give some experience with the difference, because we have had all traditional forms of yoga with modern applications, right from the Jnana Yoga, the Upanishad-based wisdom, meditation sessions, Kriya Yoga and the mudras and Hatha Yoga, Ashtanga Yoga, Iyengar Yoga and what not. Even yesterday night you had some yogic sleep and all the sessions you had, and Bhakti Yoga and all that we had. So I thought today let's, you know, have some lighter experience. And visually, I've seen that many people who are participating here are also participating with the whole family. So we have children who are essential parts of our family. They are the future generation of the nation and the world as well. So what is that we can give to them through yoga? So that is this session of Kriya Yoga. And child is not just by age, right? Child is, to be a child is by heart. And that way there is a child, there's an inner child in each one of us. So therefore this session we are doing is to bring out the child in you. So let's all now forget whatsoever our biological age would be. Let's forget all those. And manasa, vachasa, even kaya with our sharira, let's, you know, become children and enjoy this session. And as rightly Vinayji said, I have a few of my colleagues, my students with me to join me in certain activities, because this is more an activity based session. I would be very happy if I would be able to see all of you. By now we have more than 120 participants here, and the rest who are also witnessing in our Zoom in the other platform. So I'll be very happy to see all of them, and so that, you know, I can interact with you. But unfortunately this platform doesn't permit everybody to be here. So I visualize, I assume you that you're all there in front of me, and on your behalf representing all of you for a few activities, I would welcome a few of our colleagues who are here. I would like to just introduce them, and then they will go mute with their video. When required, they will come back again. We have with us Dr. Asha Manjunath, who is here with us, and she's a very regular participant of this entire Global Festival of Yoga. Religiously, she had been attending all the sessions. We have with us Shri Achala Abhinaya Raju, who is with us, and who is a very active yoga teacher in our institute. So welcome her also. We have with us Praveen Mungerwadi. So he's also a very active teacher of us from Hubli. He has joined with us. So welcome Praveen also. We have also Praveen, another very enthusiastic yoga teacher who was trained at Adhyatma Yoga, and also who is a teacher at Rashtotana group of schools and part of Samvit team. So he is with us also. He is an expert in the Kriya Yoga better than me as well, actually. So thank you, Asha Didi. You can keep your video muted, and I'll call you back when I need you all. So with this, welcome you all once again, and let's see what this session today, what we are seeing, and what is it all about. Yeah, again, so this session, as was introduced, it's about Kriya Yoga. So to bring out the child in you, which is presented by me. And there is a beautiful, you know, verse from Thiruvalluvar. Yesterday, Dr. Vetri was quoting a lot from the Siddhas and Tamil literature. So I would like to quote one of the verse from Thirukural of Thiruvalluvar, where he says, you know, Thirukural is something where you have 1,330 verses on the Chaturvedha Purushartha. The theme itself is based on Chaturvedha Purushartha, Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha. And in which, when it comes to the Artha and Kama, it's all about the Grihastashrama life, the family life. And where he 10 couplets, he is mentioning about children, Makkal Peer, where he says, Perumavatrul yam arivadu illai arivarinda makkal peru allapira. There is no other treasure that I value more other than having children who are wise enough to know what needs to be known. So it's very important to have the progeny, the children, and then, you know, when you have intelligent children, what more than that? And celebrating childhood is very much part of our tradition, our heritage, our Sanatana Dharma. Balam Mukundam Manasasmarami. Krishna being looked upon as a child, all his pranks, you know, we enjoy Bala Krishna. Even Tulsidas and other saints also look at Rama as Bala Rama. Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa had the vision of Rama as Bala Rama, and he played with him with the Vatsalya Bhava. So many kavis here, they celebrate this childhood of the divine avatars. Today we are celebrating the Avatara Dinam, the Jayanti of a great woman saint, Andal. Andal is looked upon as, she was born Ayonija under a Tulsi plant in Tamil Nadu in Srivalliputtur to Periyalvar, a Vaishnava saint, today on Adipuram, and means thousands of years back on this day. So she was taken as a child, and then as a small child, all the pranks that she does, she was enjoying Krishna's presence as a child, enjoying Krishna's leelas, and all these were happening. So that is the beautiful thing that we see. So even as a woman goddess, she is celebrated as a child, Andal, today, whose birthday we are celebrating. So some of the activities of children that we do in Adhyatma Yoga, very soon, probably in 15 days time, you know, we are having Sri Krishna Janmashtami coming, then you'll see all these beautiful children around. So we need to just understand childhood. So today, you know, we have the subject of development psychology, based on which how we try to look upon childhood is, according to development psychology schools, you know, the school life of children is looked upon, divided into three stages: the early childhood stage, and then the late childhood, which is preteens, and adolescence or the teenage. So in this three stage that we look into children and understand what the needs of these children are, and accordingly we go ahead in doing the yoga for them. So the need is to be understood first. So today, if you see the problems faced by children of this generation, you know, one is basically they come with a lot of complaints of lack of concentration, especially parents today and teachers today, you know, share a lot of problems that they, concerns that they face. I would not say it is a problem, but it's a concern. Lack of concentration, then lack of memory, and then lack of confidence, you know, and diversions are too much for children, as you know today. And therefore, as a result of it, students get stressed out a lot. In our school days or college days, we never heard of the word stress. Today, a third standard student comes to me and says, you know, bhaiya, I want to learn yoga. I said, why do you want to learn yoga? I'm so stressed, bhaiya, I want to learn yoga, he comes and says. A student of third standard. In future, we may even hear LKG, UKG children telling this. So stress has become something, you know, common. And as they grow to higher classes, you have the problems of anxiety, exam stress. They have, you know, concerns of decision making, which is all resulting into various health hazards as well. And added to that, when children go into their teenage and adolescence, you know, a lot of other things of the family problems between parents. And today, I don't have to say, world over, we see the drug culture and terror and all entering even the school days itself. And currently, we are even using technology for a good cause, for the Global Festival of Yoga and for teaching yoga online as well. But usually, overexposure to media, social media, and television, and all those things are also causing a lot of concerns for children especially. And it's not only children, for everybody as such. So the big concern today if not recognized and treated properly, it lead into a lot of problems like hyperactivity, learning disabilities, health hazards, and psychosocial complications like depression and anxiety and all those. So what is the way for it? What is the solution? So we need to look into a holistic personality development of children. Unfortunately, what is happening in today's education? I just remember kind of an incident. It so happened that an explorer, explorer is like, people like Vasco da Gama or Columbus. So this kind of an explorer was going through a deep forest and he was caught by a group of cannibals. And once he was caught by the cannibals thought, wow, we have got a good, delicious food for our king. So they took him and then presented to the king. The king was happy to see this guest. He said, oh, you're an explorer. Where do you come from? Which country do you belong to? He said, probably the United States of America. And he asked him, oh, you come from the United States or you come from the England. I have also been abroad and I have done my master's degree there. And he says, oh, you've done a master's degree there, but still you're a cannibal. You're eating human. He says, so what? I have learned how to use that fork and the knife. You understand? We are very sophisticated. We do a lot of education today, but lacking the basic human culture today. And that is the system of education that today we are facing. Unfortunately, the modern education, no matter whether it is in India or abroad, anywhere, I'm not talking about a particular country or anything. It's a bad effects of the modern education system that we are facing. And so we need to look for a holistic solution for holistic personality development as such. And that's where, all-round personality development, which is also an accepted pattern by the WHO, we have, is having the physical, emotional, intellectual, social, and spiritual growth of the child as such, the multifaceted development. And therefore, we have the yogic concept of personality, which is already familiar to you, all the participants. So many people have presented on this, the Annamaya Kosha, Pranamaya, Manomaya, Vijnana, and Anandamaya Kosha, the five sheets of existence, personality development, based on the Panchakosha Vivek of Taittiriya Upanishad. I see my master, Sri Raghuramji, is present here in the attendees also, who is like a master who had taught me this Panchakosha. I'm so happy that he is here as well. So also we have the four streams of yoga, the concept of looking into yoga, not only as asana, only as pranayama. By now we know, we have understood the holistic concept, including even the food and various aspects. So we have the four streams of yoga as such put together, leading towards the same goal of the Sampurna Vyaktitva Vikasa of the child as such to see. Particularly, when you see the system of Raja Yoga, I see it as a beautiful tree as presented by Dr. B.K.S. Iyengar in one of his books. So it is, holistic something, the roots being the yama, the don'ts, the stem being the do's, the niyama, the branches being the asanas, and the leaves being the pranayama, and then the tree bark being pratyahara, the withdrawal of senses from the sensory organs, and then the sap, the juice being dharana, the flowers being dhyana, meditation, and fruit of samadhi. Such a wonderful representation. See, we are talking of teaching yoga to children. When we teach them also, this kind of illustrations will help them to understand better. We need to go with examples, always an example, a story to connect children with higher concepts. That's how we use to tell them, even in some of the schools in through Samvit Research Foundation, where I'm involved as a advisor and a team member for setting the syllabus curriculum for school children. We have brought out this concept of Ashtanga Yoga based on Patanjali, and how in each class, right from even first standard, we introduce Ashtanga Yoga, all these concepts, but age-wise, according to their age, how we can suit them. So when you even make them understand the concept, the bigger concept of Ashtanga Yoga through an illustration of just a tree. Sometimes the Panchakosha, we use the example of a car journey, the body being the car and the petrol being the Pranamaya Kosha, and then the engine being the Manomaya Kosha, the mind, and driver is the intellect, as Upanishad says, Buddhim to Saratem Viddhi, driver is the intellect, and the traveler, the passenger, the Atma, the soul, Ananda, the Anandamaya Kosha is a traveler who is making his journey happy, enjoying it, and the path being the path of yoga. So like this, if you give examples to make children understand, it is very nice. So this is how we try to present the whole concept of yoga. And so therefore we saw the need that today children are lacking, you know, all this. And that is where I would also, you know, try to tell you, because you're all already kids here. There are one forty-seven children are here, right? So you should all determine now to which class you belong to. I would prefer all of you to be in LKG or a pre-KG. That is the best, right? So all of you should now put in your chat box which class you belong to. Okay, you go back to your school, which school and which class, pre-KG, LKG, whatever it is. Now I have a thing to suggest you, one story I will share you. We are seeing Swami Vivekananda here, right? Children, how many of you have seen Swami Vivekananda? Put your hands up. Yeah, you're seen, yes? Where? The picture right behind me and in the book and everything. And you see Swami Vivekananda to be a great oracious reader. He had been a great oracious reader. And it so happens that he gets a volume of encyclopedia. I'm sure you all are, today we are in the age of the Wikipedia. When any assignments are given by the teachers, we just go and browse in the global guru called Google, and Wikipedia gives us the notes. But in those days, you know, it was encyclopedia in the library. Each volume of encyclopedia will be more bigger than a pillow as such. So what happens? He goes and brings a volume of encyclopedia, gives the same day and takes another volume like this. Every day he takes a big volume of encyclopedia and gives it. And then the librarian had a doubt. Is this Swamiji reading at least a few pages? Swamiji's disciples said, no, he's not just reading a few pages, but he's reading the entire volume of encyclopedia in a few minutes or perhaps an hour, which is having more than 300-400 pages. How is it possible? He said, our Swamiji does. If you have any doubt, you can come and cross-verify. You can ask our Swamiji. Children, so the librarian goes to Swami Vivekananda. He asks a doubt. Swamiji, I'm told by your disciple that you are reading the whole book in a few minutes. How is it possible? He says, yes, of course I do. If you have any doubt, you can ask me any question from this book. These are the so many volumes I've completed so far. You can ask me anything. And he said, then later Swamiji said, you don't have to even tell me a question or tell me a concept. Tell me the page number, I can tell whatever is there. This fellow was telling, okay, page number 348, something randomly. Oh, it is Indica Yoga. Indica Yoga is a very great yoga platform with authentic, transformative, informative, immersive form of yoga, which is led by Dr. Vinay Chandra, whatever, blah, blah, blah. It is all written there. Everything verbatim Swami Vivekananda was telling, page after page, volume after volume, everything he was telling without missing a full stop or a comma. And then the librarian had the chakkar, you know, he had the shake of his head. He said, come on, are you not, I think you are a robo 2.0. No, I'm not a robo. I'm a man. You can touch and feel me. I'm just a human like you. Then the librarian asked, Swamiji, then how did you get this much of memory? I also read a lot. Children, we also, whatever is taught in the school, we go back and try to recollect everything we are remembering. But when it comes to exam, when you go and sit there and the teacher asks you a question, you were remembering until you entered the exam hall. Once the teacher asks you the question, everything forgotten. You know. So from where do we get this memory from? So Swamiji said, you know, what is the answer of Swamiji to the librarian? Can anybody guess and share with me? You can share in the chat box. If anybody knows the answer, what Swami Vivekananda would have shared? He said that I have been doing yoga for 12 years. I'm doing yoga, meditation, sadhana for 12 years. And that has helped me in getting this much of memory. Look at his photographic memory, children, that he has to just look into the pages and everything in the pustaka will catch up in his mastaka, like a camphor. You know, pustaka means the book, mastaka is our head. So all that in his pustaka will go into mastaka. How did he get this focus and concentration? Rightly, as Padmalata says, yes, it is because of the yoga practice that he had been doing. So we need to look into, you know, kind of how the practice of yoga can help us. So coming back, you know, I told the holistic approach of the Ashtanga yoga, all it's a beautiful tree, you know, it's a human tree. In Bangalore, there is a beautiful company even called, a software company called the Mind Tree. So yoga is this mind tree. And we have to also see how we can learn yoga. Yeah, so now when it comes to yoga, what happens? many of the so-called yoga teachers, yoga masters, you see them, they're very serious. Yoga means so serious. You should close your eyes, sit straight, and you know, or stand in one leg, stand in upside down, and do all those things. Yeah, that is all they require. But you don't have to be so serious for that, especially with children, right? Today, unfortunately, what is happening, you know, now even the other side, many of you are parents here, you know, many of your teachers here, we are expecting children to become adults. We are not letting them to enjoy their childhood, right? Imagine the way we all enjoyed in our childhood. I know many of you have, you know, crossed your 30s, 40s. There are many who have in your 60s, 70s, in your real bodily age. Though mentally, we are all children of PKG today. But the fact is that we are all aged. Now, just imagine when in our childhood days, we all had such a fun being in our native villages and everywhere, no matter whichever country you belong to. Doesn't matter whether it is Germany or Switzerland or UK or America. When we all were in our childhood days, those who have crossed your 40s, at least 30s, 40s, in our childhood days, we were so much friendly with nature. We were going around, you know, in India, at least you all remember, we used to hang swings on the trees, the mango trees and everything. We used to go and play there, you know, in the woods and all those things. Now children are missing all those. They have become serious, you know, software engineers, IT professionals sitting in the online and working, you know. And so they are losing that childhoodness, you know. So therefore, in fact, in yoga, we used to say, a real yogi will be childlike, not childish. We should not be childish. To be childlike is the beautiful sense of being a yoga sadhaka. So do not expect children to become adults. Do not rob them of their innocence and joyful play. So when we teach yoga, we should remember this, give them that, you know, childhood feel, and then they should be able to enjoy yoga in a better way. And of course, remember, you are never too old to let your inner child play. It's not just about children. So what I'm presenting today, it's not about only for children, even we elders who are grown up physically, but even there is an inner child in all of us. So you look at Krishna. At one side, he is a serious Gitacharya who is spearheading the whole Kurukshetra war. But he also was always maintaining that pranks of his, you know, Bala Leelas and everything, even after growing up. So there was a balance of both. You know, in fact, when we say what yoga can help us, how yoga can benefit us, our Guruji, Dr. Nagendra, used to say, it used to give you kind of the hardness like a diamond, Vajradabhi Katorani, Mruduni Kusumadabhi, like a flower, a flexibility like a flower. So children are like flower. As we are growing, yes, we need to become, Swami Vivekananda said, you should have, you know, strong muscles of iron and nerves of steel and intellect like a thunderbolt. So vajra, everything like this you should have, vajra sharira you should have, but the mind should be always like a child, the inner child, you know, you should never lose it. So you are never too old to let your inner child play. So let's all join to go into this. Now coming to, okay, now as I told, yoga should not be serious. We should make it in a very nice way to make it easy for children. So in our kids yoga, maybe in my parent organization at SVyasa, or at Yog Bharti, or now at Adhyatma Yoga, the kids yoga, when we introduce, we have a creative methodology. And now more, I'm connected with two organizations where I have been introducing this kids yoga. One is Disha Bharat, where Viveka Vikasa in schools, you know, we do go and do. And I train those trainers, and then they go and train the students in turn. And also even in Youth for Seva, all their volunteers who go to different schools, government schools, and do their service projects. I train them also, all those volunteers, with the methodology to teach yoga to children. And also in Samvit Research Foundation, which is part of Rashtrottana Parishad, I train all the group of yoga teachers with this creative methodology. So it should be creative, fun-based way of teaching yoga to kids. Let's see, what is this creative? So C, C for celebrative, and, you know, or for rhythmic. It should be a celebrative. Your yoga class should be a celebration. It should not be too serious, you know. Look at the way when you go to the presence of great yoga masters like Sri Sri Ravi Shankar Ji, you feel like being in the presence of a mother, won't you? So that is how it should be. It should become a celebration. Nityotsava. It should be a utsava, yoga utsava. The yoga festival, global festival, is not just 30 days or 40 days what we are doing. Every yoga session should be a celebration, a real festival. And the yoga, when you teach, it should have a rhythm, you know, all throughout. There should be a connection, a rhythm. So R for rhythmic, I would say, and the E for enthusiastic, enthusiasm, utsahat bhalavan aryaha, natutsahat param bhalam. So utsaha, it should be bubbling with enthusiasm, kids. So we should enjoy and do it. So enthusiastic and enjoying. E for both, enthusiasm and enjoy. And A for artistic. You know, bring colorful artistic things into that. When you present them, you know, you can present such, if you see my slides, that's why I have made it also very artistic, colorful, because we are children. Children relate to that. And you should build T for team spirit. Not just, it's not single individual oriented. We should bring all children together. That is where together they grow. And of course, I for innovative. Yes, you're going to see now how in innovative way I'm going to make you all learn and do yoga today. So our children create, kids yoga should be also innovative. And V for vibrant. The class should be not like this monotonous, only teacher is teaching. It should also make a lot of huge noise. Now what? Let's all make noise. Come on. Yes. Let's all say Jai, Jai Ho. Yes. It should be very vibrant. You know, it's not a serious physics class or max class. It is yoga class. It should be fun, vibrant. Yes. And then finally, energetic. Every student should feel energetic by being in the class, right? So yoga itself is, as our Dr. Nagendra used to call, it's a human engineering, as Sadhguru calls today as energy engineering. Sorry, it's inner engineering, as Sadhguru calls, and as I call it, it's energy engineering. So energetic it should be. So that is the creative methodology which we apply in the yoga class. So let's see how we are going to translate this concept of this creative, fun-based learning of yoga. It can apply to any subject. I just made it for teaching yoga, but the same acronym can be applied for any subject for children. May it be for mathematics, may it be for science, may it be for physics, English. You know, I was blessed enough to have such wonderful teachers during my school days, not in my college days that much, but in my school days, that I had such excellent teachers who brought this creative method. They didn't teach me yoga, but whatever they taught was also like yoga. So that is how I enjoyed my school days, thanks to all those teachers. Of course, engineering was a kind of tough subject, which when I studied, for me, my mind was not in that engineering, electronics and communication. I always wanted to get into the inner engineering of yoga. So that today, after finishing that, when I got into my post-graduation in SVASA, I got it, this human engineering from Dr. Nagendra, Raghuramji, and Nagratna Didi, Mohanji, whom I'm remembering, I'll share about him today. So all those we have learned. So what are the essential components in this fun-based way of teaching yoga to children, the creative methodology? We use a lot of activity. Friends, children are very action-oriented. You know, don't make them too much of intellectual. Of course, that brain development all happens. So jnana is important. But, you know, they are very action-oriented karma yogis. So the entire methodology should be action-oriented. So we include action songs. You know, there are different songs. It could be even your simple rhyme. Whatever rhyme which you are using in the school days, for which you can put into action. For example, the Bihar School of Yoga, they use I am a little teapot. So there's a song. So for which they use some yoga asanas as the action. You can use mudras, the breathing, all those, and make actions for songs which are becoming enjoyable for children. Then rhythmic yoga, asana flow to music. You play today that is becoming very popular. People, there is a recent video which has been published in the social media called natyobics, like aerobics, it's called natyobics, dance movements. Likewise, yoga movements to the flow of music, we can do it also. That's what Nritya Yoga, I call it. So many sessions we did have in the Indica Yoga also. Madam Siri from Singapore and many others. There was another team of people together, they presented this dance movements for yoga. So I use this dance movements to the chant of shlokas. Wonderful shlokas, meaningful shlokas of Krishna's pranks and everything that we have on Ganesha. So we can use those yogic movements to make these happen. And bhajans, all those I will give you today, a trailer of all this, my dear friends. And yoga asana, pyramid formation, thematic formation, the children together, the team spirit is involved. And also yoga need not be only asanas, you know. You have to tell them the yama, niyama and everything, which is very essential. So we use stories to tell them the yogic values of yama, niyama and everything. And even with stories, yoga asanas. I usually tell a Panchatantra story or a Dashavatara story, Rama, Krishna, Shiva story. And the action for the stories, while listening to me the stories, I will also be imitating, I'll be doing some of the actions and children will also enjoy doing it. And ultimately, what are those actions? They're all wonderful yoga asanas. Friends, we have 84 lakhs of asanas. So, and all those asanas, apparently, you know, 90% of the asanas are named after animals, birds, fishes and all natural elements, like trees. You have Parvatasana on the mountain, and you know, on earth, Bhunamana, everything. So you can use all those and make nature-based themes. You know, one day you can take the theme of all the wild animals and teach them accordingly. Use sounds, how the lion will roar, how the tiger will, you know, roar, how the cat or dog will, you know, use. So all those, you know, for example, we have simple, you know, dog breathing. How do we do that? You know, you can make them to be in Vajrasana like dogs, and then, you know, they will, when they do it, it's an enjoyable thing. You can all do it because this dog breathing is very helpful in this COVID situation also, to build up our immunity, to bring the respiration in a nice way. So it's very helpful. So I would like you all to join me in this simple technique of the dog breathing. Yeah. Now you can all sit in, if possible, if you know Vajrasana, you can all sit in Vajrasana. If not, just like that, however you are sat, you can sit. And bring your palms by the side of the knees like this, and open your mouth, tongue protruded out, and you'll start exhaling forcefully by flapping the abdomen, just like dog. Just imagine how it'll be fun for children. Come on, let's all become whichever dog that you want. You are not able to see me? Yeah.
Subhabhaiya, could you just go back a little bit, and so that we can see the entire position once?
Yeah. That's okay. Even if you don't see my asana, that you can, if you're sitting, however you are in chair or something, also still you can do this. It's like this. You're sitting when your abdomen is pressing on the thighs, and open your mouth. Close your mouth. Just come back to the Vajrasana and sit there with eyes closed. Relax. You can, you know, put your head down and relax in Sashankasana as well. And that's how we do. So these kind of, you do only focus on the exhalation. Don't worry about the inhalation. Inhale once using your nostrils, and then like Kapalabhati. You're familiar, most of us are familiar. Last night also Ketki taught us Kapalabhati. So like this, you can do continuous exhalation. So when you do this, you know, kind of things, there is a rapid breathing. I don't have much time to do this. I'll go into more of the Kriya Yoga part of it. But generally the methodology is, when you take these postures or breathing, which are connected to nature, animal, children love to do that. They will have wonderful fun and do that. So going back. So all those, you know, when you use, for example, you just think of Dashavatara. You know, we can make them do all the asanas with Dashavatara. You have Matsyasana, Kurmasana, you know, Varahasana, all those. We have Narasimha, Simha Mudra, which I'll make you do also. And for Rama, Dhanurasana, you know, Halasana for Balarama, Krishna. So many asanas that you can involve for Krishna. Like this, you use Ashvasanchalana for Kalki. So Padmasana for Buddha, all the Dashavataras, we can make them do with all the asanas. And also most important component when you teach children, Hasya Yoga, laughter. Today laughter has become very popular, and you'll have it. I don't believe in the system of separately telling you to come on, laugh, laugh, laugh. You know, there is a laughter yoga, what they make is, it's like artificial. They tell you, come on, everybody laugh. So it's not like that. The laughter should be a natural laughter. So that I will assure you that you're going to have a lot of laughter and fun today. And that is another important thing. So on various other activity based, with, for example, a concept of Swachh Bharat, which is the cleanliness campaign today, what we have in India. And then we can take them. Usually I prefer taking the children for outside walk, and then teach them yoga in the nature. So you can see some of our sessions, how we are doing. So these are the different activities. We use a lot of props, you know, and make them do various things. The balloon, which we have, you know, for example, when you teach them how to do the breathing, the belly breathing, abdominal breathing, diaphragmatic breathing. So you can use the example of a balloon, how you blow air into the balloon, it blows out. When you take the balloon out, you know, air out, it gets shrinked. That's how the stomach is a balloon. So we tell them and use balloons to make them do asana together. One child is passing the balloon to the other, he's catching. So they're passing the ball downward. So they are bending downward. So they are going sideward. So all games, when they do this game also, and they are also doing yoga asanas also. So some of our sessions of Dhyatma Yoga, which you are seeing here. And coming to this Krida Yoga, which is kind of games involving games in yoga. So we have a lot of things, for example, for memory, memory games, team building games, where more people together they will play, and games based on the themes of Yama, Niyama, physical asana based games. We have breathing based games we have. And also, as you see in the other slide there, so indoor games, outside when you do a single line game, double line game, circle game, collective, a lot of such things are there. We will see a few what we could do today. So we shall now start again to some of the practices. I ask all of you to join with me in some of the practice. So first we shall do a few games, and I want you all to respond, you also to participate. I request some of my colleagues who are here to join with their audio and video so that you can see how they respond. They will represent you, other kids. These will join me in doing. Okay. Now the first game that we do, the first set of games that we are doing, these are mental games. Means mental in sense mind, not just, mental means not a mental patient or something. It's a kind of mental game. First, this is maybe a pen or a chalk that I have taken. So this is Govinda game. Okay. So Govinda, you all know Govinda, Tirupati Balaji. Yeah. And you have a film star also called Govinda. So when I throw this, to the height of way, how much I have thrown it, you have to say Govinda. So whenever I throw this pen up, I'm sorry. Whenever I throw this up, so you have to say, what do you say? I'm not hearing you. Should all, Praveen, your audio, everybody, your audio. Uh-huh. Praveen, Achala, Asha, the other Praveen. Yeah. Even Anuji, everybody can join. So just watch it carefully here. Your eyes should be watching here. Okay.
Govinda.
All together at the same time. Okay.
Govinda.
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 I didn't put it all. See. Okay.
Govinda.
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 Govinda. Govinda. I didn't put it all. Okay. So just a kind of thing, how your eyes coordinate. So children's eyes vision coordination happens very well in this. Also, now careful, another game which I will tell you. I am going to teach you some of the yoga mudras. We have learnt many of the mudras in Indica Yoga's various session also. So we all know, what is this mudra?
Namaskara.
Namaskara mudra. This is Nasika mudra. Okay, Nasika mudra. This is very famous.
Chin mudra.
Chin mudra. Yeah. And this is Chinmaya mudra. See, when you fold in Chin mudra, fold the other fingers. Yes. Chinmaya mudra. All the 162 kids, everybody are doing. Okay. Chinmaya mudra. Show me. Yes. Good. And this is Adi mudra, which you make for making kusti, fun with your friends. Adi mudra. Yeah. And this is Shanmukhi mudra. What is it?
Shanmukhi
mudra. Now, you are going to do the mudra which I say. Kya karna hai? You are going to do the mudra I say. Let's start. It's a game. Okay. Chin mudra. All of you. Chinmay mudra. Namaskara mudra. Shanmukhi mudra. Adi mudra. Chin mudra. Nasika mudra. Chin mudra. Adi mudra. You should say, Yara Tapmadi, Selpa. Praveen, Achala. Chin mudra.
Kya mudra? Chinna.
Chinmay mudra. Adi mudra. Achala, you are wrong. Praveen, you are wrong. You are out. Chin mudra. Chinmay mudra. Anu, you are wrong. Chin mudra. Chinmay mudra. आदि मुद्रा नासिका मुद्रा स्वल्प करेक्ट मारे पर चिन मुद्रा चिन्मय मुद्रा आदि मुद्रा नमस्कार मुद्रा नासिका मुद्रा good kids now all of you did very well let's give a good clap to all of you
which clap
yes a new clap we will give now we will all give a flower clap to all of you take your hands up and shower the flowers in Kriya Yoga we have lot of class I can teach you 108 varieties of claps okay now the second we have time running short so now what did you learn in this game okay I told you to do the mudra I say you were going wrong because you were following you were you know imitating the mudras which I was doing some people who went wrong so you were watching what I was doing but I did not do what I was saying so children watch what we do than what we say so this is a lesson for teachers and parents also what we say and what we do should be together you know who is the mahatma manasyekam vachasyekam karmanyekam mahatmanah so children we should teach them
translate
oh yes what we think and what we speak what we do everything should be the same that's what the scriptures teaches so yoga is that what you think what you speak what you do everything should be same so in my case I was telling something I was doing something else so these kids who are imitating me so they were more following what I was doing and they were getting wrong though they were knowing they knew what right what mudra they should do but they were getting wrong because they were imitating me so this is just a simple way we are teaching mudra also to children you have to teach them mudra so you are teaching the mudras also they later can add the benefits everything you can tell them and you are also imbibing them a lesson a moral lesson of what you speak and what you do should be the same together right so another small game that you will play to quickly okay this is kayenge game yeah you're all I'm actually hungry it's already 7:45 it's my soup time I don't take the breakfast I have a brunch but I have usually a cup of soup in the morning so I'm getting hungry so let's try to eat some breakfast okay there are many of my friends brothers and sisters from other countries so in India to eat we say khayenge okay khayenge so now I will be giving you lot of eatables and you are going to eat by saying khayenge okay of course I don't know let me try most of the eatables I know are Indian they are Indian cuisine so idli dosa and Indian foods are loved by everybody all over the world
Dinesh.
I'm sure you all will enjoy that so let's all get ready so whenever as I'm serving you various things I can give you something that which is not eatable also maybe I can throw some stone I can put some mud I can throw some chalk piece so you have to be alert your hearing skills are important you have to be alert to eat what you want to eat sometimes I can give you junk food also okay so you are all good kids right so you know the other day we have heard Apar uncle speaking about right food right way of eating dr Apar uncle came and told us right yuktahara what you should eat and what you should not eat right remember so remember that and consciously let's play this okay let's eat ready keep your plate ready idli
khayenge
dosa
khayenge
puri
khayenge
samosa
khayenge
stone idli
khayenge
dosa
khayenge
puri bread biscuit pizza lays kurkure nakayake yes good kids again okay let's eat some poha avalakki tavige lemon rice chak pis you're all very alert good but most kids at that time you know they in schools when you do at large you are 3-4 kids you are grown up kids so you're alert imagine when I'm teaching for 40-50 kids so sab kuch khayenge and for them by then chalk piece pen everything would have become favorite they will start biting it already we have all done it in you know schools right I'm seeing many of the parents are sharing yes I know already you know many of them are sharing the comments so like this, so their alertness, that how, what they listen when you're when you're in a fastness telling various things along with that, so what to choose. So their listening skills improve by this, and alertfulness. Okay, I know out of all this given, what do I pick up? Like this, we have various memory games also. So some games where yoga is directly involved, these are the yogic benefits of cognitive faculties in the indirect way involved. Now let's go into some direct yoga practice sessions with fun. We will go into that. So I will again share my slide. Oh, what happened? Yeah. What do you see here, kids? What do you see here? Butterfly, right? Yeah. So let's also become butterfly. Yeah. Let's also become a butterfly. Now, all of you. Ah. I think I'll. You should come to Baddha Konasana like this. Are you able to see me?
Can you just, huh?
Yes. I need the shawl only up to the theory. Now in the practice, all those are not needed. So you're going to keep like this. So this is a well-known posture that we do, Baddha Konasana, in a preparatory thing that we all do in yoga. Oh, very good. There are quite good kids. Wow, we have, who is that? Ankita. Yes, Ankita, welcome. Nice. So you have to keep like this, and you're going to do the butterfly. Now you are joining with me. Repeat after me. I'm a little butterfly.
I'm a little butterfly.
I'm a little butterfly.
I'm a little butterfly.
I have wings.
I have wings.
I'm a little butterfly. I have wings.
Butterfly.
I fly around. Roll your neck. I fly around. I see all the things.
I see all the things.
I'm a little butterfly.
I'm a little butterfly.
I have wings.
I have wings.
When I see a flower.
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 Ah, yes, sorry. When I see a flower, that looks great. When I see a flower, that looks great.
That looks great.
I call out to all my mates. I call out to all my mates. I'm a little butterfly, I have wings. I'm a little butterfly, I have wings. Very good. Now, you know, the butterfly is trying to fly to Akasha and Patala, to, you know, to the sky and to the earth. So how does it do it? So Akasha, look up, Patala, bring your forehead to the toes. Akasha, Patala. Akasha, Patala. Yes. Those who have a big Madhya Pradesha like me, you can't reach the Patala. So you should do yoga every day to cut off your Madhya Pradesha. Come on, Akasha, Patala. Akasha, Patala. Yes, come on. Yes, so we have done the warm-up. We have prepared our body. Now we go into more serious asanas that we are going to look into. Now, I have a quiz for you, okay? I have a quiz for you. Again, I go to my slide. Whom do you see here? Who is going to share?
Salumardati Makka.
Salumardati Makka. Let's give a good clap to Praveen. Yeah, Praveen, why is she famous? Or who is she actually? Salumardati Makka, we know in Karnataka, some of us know. Yeah, Anu is telling something. Let's ask to.
Can you type out her name on the thing so that everybody, yeah, there.
Yeah. Achala, type out the name in the chat, Achala.
Nitya ji has done it.
Yeah. So, can somebody say me why do we, you know, regard Salumar Timakka as a very great person, my dear kids?
She got Padma Shri.
For what? She got Padma Shri for what?
She taught yoga for many.
I'm sorry, you're wrong, Asha. Praveen Mungurwadi, you want to share?
She planted the trees.
She planted trees, thousands of trees. Yes, Praveen. Yeah?
Yes.
Yes. Yeah, she planted. Yes, Hamsa, you're right. Yes, Saibal Chakravarti, you're right. Meghana, everybody, yes, you're right. Because she planted trees, you know, thousands of trees that she planted, right? So she is a mother of many trees. She is not, biologically, she is not the mother of a child, but she took trees as her children. So trees are very important for us, right, children? We have already seen how we correlated Ashtanga yoga with the tree. Then look at the tree in which all the kids are doing wonderful yoga. So this is, I think Ankita must also be here in our camp. We take children to trees and they really, they learn to climb up the trees. Today you don't know, you know, you all play only in the video. So, but in our Adhyatma Yoga, yoga camps, we take children to the forest and we climb the trees and, you know, sometimes our Ananda and others make them go upside down on the tree and play there also. They swing in the trees and everything, right? So we are all going to now go to a forest and play with the trees, okay? Yeah. So let's get ready for going to the Bandargatta forest. It's a long time since the lockdown that we haven't gone out. So now we're all going to go to the favorite forest. In Bangalore, we have Bandargatta forest. You have Amazon forest in other countries. So all those, wherever, whichever forest you have, you're going to go. Now I want all of you to get up. Yeah. Everybody get up. All 157, 160 kids who are here. All of you to stand up and you're going to follow with me. You're going to repeat. I'm going to sing. And for the clarity, I will request here Achala to be on sound. Others, keep your thing muted. Achala, you can be loud, okay? When you repeat. No, you can have your video. Asha, you can have your video, but audio muted. Achala, you alone repeat Jorse, okay? When I say, you can repeat after me and others can also, yeah. Repeat and do this. So whatever I do, just imitate, then you'll see what it is. Yeah, now when you see a tree, what are all there in the tree? Just now we saw trees, right? Ankita, what are all there in the tree? What are all there in the tree? What do you see, tree? You see the branches, right?
Branches.
Yes. Then you see?
Leaves,
flowers, sometimes birds go and build their nest there, right? Yes. So now we are going to go to the tree and we are going to become tree, okay? You see here trees near me also. Hope I'm visible to all of you. Just repeat after me. There was a tree.
There was a tree.
And the tree on the ground.
And the tree on the ground.
And the green grass grew.
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 And the green grass grew around.
And the green grass grew around.
Very good, yes. Now what is there on the tree first? As rightly Ankita said, you have the branches. There was a branch.
There was a branch.
And the branch on the tree.
And the branch on the tree.
And the tree on the ground.
And the tree on the ground.
And the green grass grew.
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 And the green grass grew around.
And the green grass grew around.
Very nice. What is there on the branches, you see? Leaves all around, right? Yeah. There was a leaf.
There was a leaf.
And the leaf on the branch.
And the leaf on the branch.
And the branch on the tree.
And the branch on the tree.
And the tree on the ground.
And the tree on the ground.
And the green grass, all together now, okay? All together. And the green grass grew. And the green grass grew. And the green grass grew around. I'm sorry. Yes. And then you see birds going and building their nest around, okay? So there was a nest.
There was a nest.
And the nest on the leaf.
And the nest on the leaf.
And the leaf on the branch.
And the leaf on the branch.
And the branch on the tree.
And the branch
on and the tree on the ground. And the green and the green grass grew. And the green grass grew. And the green grass grew around. What will be there on the nest? Bird will go and lay its egg. Anda. Yeah. There was an egg. What happened to Achala? Praveen, you join with your audio. There was an egg.
Was an egg.
And the egg on the nest.
And the nest on the leaf.
And the leaf on the branch. And the branch on the tree. And the tree on the ground. And the green grass grew. And the green grass grew. And the green grass grew around. What will be there inside the egg? Some child told in the class, an omelet. So it's not omelet. Inside the egg, it is the chick that will be there, right? So there was a chick. This is Garudasana.
There was a chick.
And the chick on the egg.
And the chick on the egg.
And the egg on the nest.
And the egg on the nest.
And the nest on the leaf. And the leaf on the branch. And the branch on the tree. And the tree on the ground. And the green grass grew. And the green grass grew. And the green grass grew. Around. Yeah. Super. What will the birds have? The chick have? It has feathers, right? There was a feather.
There was a feather.
And the feather on the cheek.
And the feather on the cheek.
And the cheek on the egg.
And the cheek on the egg.
All together. And the egg on the nest. And the nest on the leaf. And the leaf on the branch. And the branch on the tree. And the tree on the ground. And the green grass grew. And the green grass grew. And the green grass grew. Around. Yes. What will be there on the feather? It is very colorful, right? So there was a color, and the color on the feather, and the feather on the cheek, and the cheek on the egg, and the egg on the nest, and the nest on the leaf, and the leaf on the branch, and the branch on the tree, and the tree on the ground.
And the tree on the ground.
Yeah.
The green grass grew. And the green grass grew. And the green grass grew around.
And the green grass grew around. Yes. How was it?
Super.
Yes. So did we all enjoy? Did you all do it? The others?
Yes.
The other kids there, did you all do it? Yeah. Yes.
Jyotsna, yes.
Jyotsna Gundecha is saying, Dr. Jyotsna from Pune, she's saying, oh, good. You know, amazing. Sashank Shekhar, everybody, Kalyan. Yes, good. Very good. Jai Shri. Yeah. So, what did we do now? Lots to remember. Yes. What did we do? We did yoga, of course, right? Mm-hmm. What is that you want when you go to yoga center, what do you want to do? To lose your calories, to do exercise, and then you want to sweat off. Now we have sweat off. See every children here, they sweat. And you want to improve your breathing. So when we are going up and down, we were doing the breathing. So it was breathing also involved, right? And look at how many asanas. Can somebody say what are the asanas that we did? In fact, more repetitive way. We had Vrikshasana, yes. And we had Ardhakati Chakrasana. We had Padahastasana. When you bend forward, Padahastasana, the downward, you know, the forward bend, the Padahastasana. And then you had Trayakka, Trayakkasana. And then you had Ardha Chakrasana for the egg. We did Ardha Chakrasana. And then you did Uttita Hasta, Trikonasana, with legs apart, both the hands up for the nest we did. And then we did for the bird, the cheek, it is Garudasana that we did, right? So all those repeated asanas, Hasta Uttana, Padahastasana, Vrikshasana, all this. When you ask children to stand in one asana for a long while, they can't do. But when we make this repetitive, they can enjoy. They had a nice way of enjoying the asana and doing. So that is the beauty of this. So one such asana that we have done. One such practice we have done wherein these many asanas that we have also brought in. I thankfully remember our teacher, our master who taught me this song. It is Sri Mohanji at SVASA, one of the founding pillars of SVASA University, Sri Mohanji, who is unfortunately today in a very a difficult condition with his health. You know, almost doctors are told it could be the last day. So I actually, it's very difficult for me at this time to do this session also with fun, because it is he who taught me this. You know, the song, he who taught me. Vinay was there with me when we learned. Vinay Chandra was my YIC batchmate in 2004, July. Hey, it is the same July month, Vinay Chandra ji. The same July month in 2004. Yes. We both were together at the same yoga instructor's course at SVASA, where our teacher Mohanji taught us this song. And I, it was like, for me, this is something you should, even a bhajan, I would always sing with an action. So just simply, singing the song was not good enough for me. So I improved the version with all these asanas, putting into the posture, into the song, and making this action happen. Now I have it translated into Kannada, into Tamil, into many languages also. We do it, Praveen is here with me, who made it in Kannada. So we all do it in all languages also and teach children. So they'll have songs. So when you repeat the song, this is a Vedic system. When you learn a mantra, you know, it is through the repetitive ways which happens. If you're teaching Vedic mantra, say Sahana Bhavatu, the teacher will teach the Sahana Bhavatu first line, then the second line, Sahana Bhunaktu. The student will stand from the first, then the second. The third line teacher will teach the student first, second, third. So the way of repetition only, Vedic mantras so much are remembered. So this is the way we improve our memory also for children. So this is a memory song as well as actions becoming the yoga asanas. Becomes a fun for children to learn. Yes. So thankfully, I offer this session to Sri Mohanji, our teacher, and I move to the next practice today. Okay, children. Now, if you have to have trees more, right? If you have to have trees grown more, what is more important? And what for growing trees you require, right? And for when you grow trees, you get this. That is water, right? For growing trees, you require water. And by growing trees, you get water. You get a tree. Oh, very nice. Veronica ji has said, you know, that she is 40 plus and feeling like 10 years old. And she has volunteered, I can translate the song to Spanish if you need. What if you not? It is the people who need, not we need. So very good, Veronica ji. You have to give this song in Spanish also. We'll be very happy to welcome you doing this. Thank you so much. Yeah. And so as I said, we need water, right? Where do we get water from? Where do we get water? What is the source of water to earth? It is from the rain. Okay. Shall we all get drenched in the rain? Shall we all get drenched in the rain? How many of you want to go and dance in the rain? Yes, Asha is ready. Praveen is ready. Come on, chalo. Let us all get ready to go and dance in the rain. Yeah. Now all the children get ready, and again repeat with me. We'll go for the rain song and dance. Repeat after me. If all the raindrops are candy drops and fruit drops.
If all the raindrops are candy drops and sugar drops.
It's not sugar. Sugar is not good. Actually, I was giving the sugar, but Dr. Appar, who came in the last week, he told sugar is not good for kids. So I have substituted sugar with fruits. Okay. Achala, yeah. So yeah, come on, let's do. Even candy is also not good. Let's say sweet drops and fruit drops. Okay, come on. If all the raindrops were sweet drops and fruit drops.
If all the raindrops are sweet drops and fruit drops.
Oh, what a rain that would be.
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 Standing apart with my mouth open wide.
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 Subhuji, it's frozen your screen.
Huh. What happened? Okay, yes, I think you are okay. Now, once again, we am I audible?
Yes, yes. Yeah. Yes.
Standing apart with my mouth open wide.
Standing apart with my mouth open wide.
Ha, 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 ha.
Ha, 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 ha. Ha 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 ha.
See, this is Veerabhadrasana. Ha 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 ha
ha. Ha 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 ha.
If all the raindrops are joy drops and loud drops.
All the raindrops are joy drops and loud drops.
Oh, what a rain that would be.
Oh, what a rain that would be.
Standing apart with my heart open wide.
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 Ha, 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 ha. Ha 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 ha.
Ha 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 ha.
Oh, what a rain that would be.
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 Very nice. Yeah, honey drops. Yes, Dr. Namrata Reddy said, very good. I'll make it as honey drops. Yeah, honey is good for health. Yeah, now we'll give a rain clap to all the kids. Yeah, very nice. It's a nice number. See, 1, 4, 3. We have 1, 4, 3 participants. That shows that I, Subhubhaya, love you all. I love you. 1, 4, 3. Yes. Yeah, now rain clap. How do we give? Take your hands. Each finger, the left hand, keep it like this. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Like this, we increase the fingers. Okay. And then start reducing. Let's do. Come on, Anu, yes. 1, 2. Reduce. 1 by 1.
Then we'll do the other hand also. Other hand also.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Rainstorm. Oh, what a rain that would be. Yes.
Oh, what a rain that would be.
Nice, right? Yes. So, like this, I just gave some few samples. You know, it's like a trailer for the movie. So we have so many such songs. Veronica ji has made a wonderful comment. She says, so my neighbors are watching through the windows, probably thinking I went mad. So much fun for a summer night in Virginia, USA. Yeah, Govind Raja ji has mentioned, Dr. Subhaji, super song, super practice. You know, many have got very nice feedbacks. Dorai, one of her teachers, I know, I wish he should have also joined us this morning. So he is a kids yoga trainer from Adhyatma Yoga, teaching in various schools. So he had remembered, you know, one day it so happened, Dorai ji, when he was teaching in a school in Bangalore, he was teaching this song, the tree song, to kindergarten kids. He is somebody who teaches from kindergarten to 10th class. Everybody, he goes and teaches yoga in some of the prestigious schools in Bannerghatta Road. So one day it so happened, when he was teaching this tree song yoga to the kids in kindergarten, then he went to 10th class. The 10th class student said, sir, why you are angry with us? What happened? I was never angry. No, you are teaching all nice yoga to the kids and not teaching us very serious yoga. So you should teach us this. So they demanded the right to teach him the tree song yoga, even in 15 years children. So we think they are teenage, they are grown up. So children are children always. Like, we experience the inner child in all of us. So we have children in every one of us, right? So in schools, this is all more in demand. So we have made many such songs. For example, I have made the song of Jnana Yoga to make people know what you are, right? We say, we heard in the Upanishads, knowing that which everything else is known. Other day, Anuji also referred that. And you know, it's all about knowing you, aham brahmasmi ityadi. So a simple song, you know, it's Swami Shivananda of Rishikesh usually makes very simple English songs, and he teaches bhajans. He makes it all very simple English songs, you know. So I was inspired by that. Know thyself, knowledge is the wealth. Knowing thyself is knowing everything. Know your real strength. Come on, everybody, you are not this body. Come on, everybody, you are not a man nor a woman. Then what are we? Know that you are Atman. Know that you are Atman. Know thyself. Knowledge is the wealth. Knowing thyself is knowing everything. Know your real strength. Like this, we have a song of Pratyahara. You know, Pratyahara is a withdrawal of sense organs from sensory objects. So nowadays we are watching more TV and everything. So there's a song I teach children. Oh, be careful, little eyes, what you see. Oh, be careful, little eyes, what you see. Like this, it goes. Oh, be careful, little ears, what you hear. Oh, be careful, little mouth, what you speak. It goes, it's a big song. Oh, be careful, little mind, what you think. There is Atman within you. It's watching all you do. Oh, be careful, little hands, what you do. Oh, be careful, little legs, where you go. Like this, teaching the Vedantic principles also through simple songs and actions, which are yogic actions, and making children understand these concepts via actions and fun. They have fun. They are having so much of enjoyment in all those. And also, they are doing, right? Very nice. Actually, one of our panelists, and who is Suresh. He says, I'm 70 plus, transformed back into 7 years. who is doing a PhD of Life University. Wow, very nice. At 70 years, he's doing a PhD. And he said he has gone back to 7 years. Very nice. And also, I will now give you a sample of another different game. Okay? Which is to show your pranayama in a different way. I think we have Praveen and others who are there. You can also use this. Other participants who are with us, other kids also, you can make small pieces of paper. I forgot to bring the papers. So Praveen, you can show. Maybe you can put Anuji, you can put Praveen. I think I can make him one of the Praveen to be on spotlight. This Praveen who is showing the chits.
Srinivasji, can you make him on the spotlight, please?
Praveen, yes. Srinivasji or Ramprasadji, you can make him. Is he there on the spotlight now? Yeah, yes. So you see him having various sheets of paper with various numbers written. Just show the number separately. Show the paper separately, Praveen. See, this is 100. Yeah. 300. Yeah. Fast. 500. Yeah, these are like values. Okay. Various values. So now these papers are folded. You show the paper folded. Folded paper. Torsi, ing marchidiyala torsi. Yeah, you have just folded the paper like this. Now you see Praveen will show you. He will place it on the table or in the floor. All the, you keep it down or place all the papers in front of you. It's a very simple, effective. In lockdown, you can make children to do, you know, all these wonderful things. At home, you can, it costs nothing. We, you know, without knowing how to engage children, we make them do a lot of video games and everything. They're spoiling. Today, you go to any school, you see children with, you know, big glass and all those things, you know. In those days, when we studied in one class, if one child is wearing a glass, it's a rare thing. Now, every child, if you don't wear a glass or a lens, it's a rare thing. So they are doing a lot of digital things. So you can use them to make them play all this. Yeah. Now it is left breath game. So how, you know, you should keep a distance and then from there you should blow. I think Praveen, you should keep your camera also a bit more. You're not able to see your face. Yeah. Please, Siddharji, please go ahead. You can use all these are nothing patent. These are not mine. No, I just have been a facilitator to develop all these. You all have the permission to use this. You can teach children. If you're teaching children, that's the most happiest thing for me. Please do think. And I will also, you know, share with you more such things. Yeah. Now,
Subhuji, can Praveenji just lift the angle of his camera a little bit so that we can see his face also?
Anyway, I think he will bend now. He has to bend a bit more. But you can keep your little more. Your face is not seen, Praveen.
If you can lift the angle upward, then we'll be able to see his face as well. Yeah, beautiful. That's it. Then on little. Perfect.
Sako.
Perfect.
Now you see he has kept various values of number. So let's see how much he is going to score. Enough. You have to blow that card without going nearby, without touching, just by blowing. So if you have to blow fast, you know, you have to do a lot of inhalation also. So inhale through the nose and exhale through the mouth. Through blowing, you are going to push the papers out. Let's see what Praveen does. Yeah, come on, Praveen, your time starts now. Oh, failed. You are... Ha, little bit more. How many you will see now, how many papers have fallen, that many marks you have got. That much money you have got. You should ask your parent to give. I can't give. I'll ask your father to sponsor that much money for you for the lockdown enjoyments.
I got 1,000.
1,000. Wow. Very good. Great. Now let's see. You have two more papers. So let's see how much. I'll give you one more chance of breath, how you're going to blow. The same, no, don't worry. The same, you don't take whatever remains. See, it didn't happen. You have to do more. Yes, the more he breathed, he was able to do it. Yeah, good. Thank you, Praveen. Yeah. Come back, you can show me now. You can spotlight me now, yeah. So, yes. So that is how even simple things, using small papers and things, you know, props which are available with us nearby. So using those that we can do a lot. Now, finally, let's do a last practice. I know a lot of questions are also will be there and we need to complete also. I think there is no doubt for anybody. I think everybody are in the Anandamaya Kosha, so no questions. Questions are only about how do we share and all those things. Very nice. So that is the real thing. So Vijnanamaya Kosha, when your Vijnanamaya Kosha is active, more questions, Prashnotra happens a lot. Now today Anandamaya Kosha is active, so it's only experience, right? And experiences, yato vacho nivartante aprapya manasasaha. You can't, you know, explain through words. It's only, even the mind cannot comprehend, but only can experience, enjoy. That's what the Upanishad says. I'm so glad. Yes, you're all enjoying it. The last, you know, masterpiece, grand finale we will see. So we come into a little bit of bhakti yoga. So we all know that all yoga, yesterday Dr. Vetri also, while explaining Siddha, he said yoga all started from Adinatha Shiva, right? So Shiva is the profounder of the yoga tradition, especially the Hatha yoga tradition. And Jnana Yoga also, as Dakshinamurti, is the profounder of the Jnana Yoga. And as Adinatha, he's a Raja Yogi. As Dakshinamurti, Shiva is a Jnana Yogi. As Adinatha, he's a Raja Yogi. And as Tyagaraja, he's Karma Yogi. Tyagaraja is Neelakanta, who consumed poison to save the rest of the humanity and devatas. So he's Tyagaraja, who sacrificed everything. So Shiva's Tyagaraja is a great exemplary Karma Yogi. And Shiva's Nataraja is an exemplary Bhakti Yogi, right? In Chidambaram, if you go see Nataraja to be doing Ananda Tandava, what does a devotee do when he's in ecstasy? You see Mirabhai and Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, Chaitanya and everybody, they would all dance in ecstasy, right? So like this, so Shiva as dancing yogi, as Nataraja is a great Bhakti Yogi. So let's all experience this Bhakti Yoga of Shiva. I think you can all join with me with the video. Your audio can be probably muted. Maybe one of you can repeat, maybe HLR, somebody can repeat the voice. Others can all just join with me with the video. You can join the practice. So come on, get ready, children. Let's all stand up to do this Natya Yoga. Yeah? Natya Yoga of Nataraja Shiva. Praveen, yes, Praveen also can join. So all of you should follow me, repeat, and do this, okay? You know, we'll do the Jai Gosha for Shiva also. This, everybody can, you can also join.
Subhubhaya, just one thing. Your legs are getting cut. So if you have any leg movements that are important, yeah, you'll not be able to see them.
Oh, yes, yes. So Nataraja's leg is most important. Okay. I think this much is enough.
Perfect, perfect.
Up to my knee level, you can, enough. Okay, light. Come on. Hara Namah Parvati Pataye. Hara Hara Mahadev. Hara Hara
Mahadev.
Hara Hara
Mahadev.
Yes. Dhimita Dhimita Dhim.
Dhimita Dhimita Dhim.
Dhimita Dhimita Dhim.
Dhimita Dhimita Dhim.
Dhimita Dhimita Dhim. Dhimita Dhimita Dhim. I think you will keep your audios muted. Both of you keep your audio muted and just follow the action. I will sing on myself. Yeah. Okay. Once again, we start. Keep your audio muted and for only the video. Dhimita Dhimita Dhim. Dhimita Dhimita Dhim. Nache Bhola Nath. Dhimita Dhimita Dhim. Dhimita Dhimita Dhim. Nache Bhola Nath. Nache Bhola Nath. Keep your audio muted. Please keep your audio muted. Nache Bhola Nath. Nache Bhola Nath. But you can repeat, okay? You keep your audio muted, but repeat song after me on your own, everybody. Nache Bhola Nath. Dhimita Dhimita Dhim. Dhimita Dhimita Dhim. Nache Bhola Nath. Nache Bhola Nath. Nache Bhola Nath. Mridanga Bhole Shiva 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 Om. Mridanga Bhole Shiva 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 Om. Veena Bhaje Hara 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 Om. Veena Bhaje Hara 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 Om. Dhamaru Bhole Shiva Om Shiva Om. Dhamaru Bhole Shiva Om Shiva. Nache Bhola Nath. 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 Nache Bhola नाथ हर नम पार्वती पतये हर हर महादेव हर हर महादेव यस वेरी नाइस यस किड्स लेट्स गिव यू ऑल अ डमरू क्लैप टेक योर डमरू डम 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 dam 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 the other day anuji presented how the maheshwara sutra from shiva's damaru how omkara and other nada came right so shiva played the damaru I'll show you the damaru wait Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Super. Long time. This is Shiva's Damaru. From where? All the Sanskrit alphabets, the bhasha, everything as such came forward. Yes. So that this is how we can use even simple bhajan. See, we did asana, natrajasana. Yeah. So Natrajasana, Veerabhadrasana, asanas connected to Shiva that we used and we did use a bhajan and enjoyed the dance here as well. So fine, that was very nice. So thank you all for joining in all this. And once again, I'll show you a few things to conclude. Yeah, today what is happening? What do you see here, kids? What do you see here, Anu?
Corona chasing the earth.
Yeah, that's what is happening today, right? So we have to chase back Corona. We should do it or not? Yes. So how do you do it? So what happened in those days when you had the wicked force coming, Lord Narasimha, who is a half lion, half animal. A half lion, half man. So he took an incarnation, avatara, from the stamba. I see, you can see a pillar behind me here also. So probably Narasimha would come out of it and throw out the corona, right? So we have to take Narasimha avatara and then throw out corona. How do we do it? So you all join with me. Come on, everybody. You can sit however you are, wherever you are, and bring your hands near your shoulders. Everybody. And keep your hand on your shoulders. And I say, ready, one, two, three. You're all going to take which avatara, which incarnation? Narasimha avatara. And you're chasing, you're vanquishing, you're devouring, you're throwing out Corona Asura. Yeah? Ready? One, two, three. Watch, first watch me, then you can all do probably. Ready? One, two, three. This is Simha Mudra. It improves your vocal cord. Children, when their voice is improving, voice culture, this is helpful for voice culture. If you are singers, speakers, it will be helpful for your voice culturing also. And all organs, also you catch all your indriyas. The eyes are coming out, so eyes are helped. Breathing happens, nose and ears get opened if there are blocks. Nose and your throat, vocal cord, speech, vak, and pani, padam. Everything gets activated when you do this particular Simha Mudra. Okay, let's all join. Ready? One, two, three. Ha! Come back again. Everybody, come on. All kids. Ready? One, two, three. Ha! Super. Simhinis. We have, I am like a Simha in between. To my right is a Simhini Anu. To my left is a Simhini Asha. What a nice way. Simhagarjana. We have a Simha. Swami Vivekananda who did the lions roaring those days, right? And a Simhini sister Nivedita behind me. So, that's how we should also roar. Against injustice, we should roar. Yeah, against corona, we should roar and throw it back. Come on, let last one, two, three. Very nice. So that's how we should take Narasimha avatara and throw away corona, chase away corona. Beautiful. And yeah, so to conclude, so what did we see? That there is a child in each one of us. of course, children are there, and we need to, you know, teach children yoga. But this yoga, all what we did, yoga, doing yoga in a lighter way. So there is a child in each one of us. So you are never too old to let your inner child play. So this Kriya Yoga with some of the games and, you know, asanas used in a fun way, with songs, with shlokas, with bhajans, with all those, you know, and claps, laughter, all this put together, this makes this Kriya Yoga, which can be practiced by practiced and benefited, not only by children. Children definitely will benefit, and of people of all ages, you know. So we forget all our thing. We have seen many people who are across 90s, you know, we have Dr. Shamanta Kamani with us, and we have seen Nanamma, who was almost near 100, Coimbatore, who was very active yogini. They were all practicing yoga even at that age. So age doesn't matter, my dear friends. So there is an inner child in all of us. So we can, you see me also playing. This was during Krishnashtami, playing the dahi handi, making the pot and everything. So always we should bring out the child in us. And to conclude, you know, I would also tell, so we, many of you have been asking, you know, can we share all this? How can we learn everything? So I have been conducting a program, kids yoga certification program, which I've been teaching only for yoga teachers. If you're already a certified yoga teacher, then you can do this. And for the past a decade, I have done a number of such programs, and I have trained hundreds of yoga trainers from all over the country, and even from abroad, people have come and got trained from me in all this. This is what some sample I showed. It's not only this. We have excellent modules for kids: eyesight improvement, voice culture, memory development, concentration development, IQ development, anger management, greed management, stress management, hormonal balance, and holistic health development, positive health. So all these wonderful modules of yoga that we have specifically designed for children, well researched modules, which has all components. This is just a small component of Kriya Yoga, which I showed you. It has various parts of it. So we have a bit of psychology there, you know, the yogic philosophy, all put together, you know, the children anatomy, all this put together. It's a beautiful course which we do. And some of the teachers who are here in the panel and in the audience also have done this course. And they all found it very useful when they go to teach children, not only at home, they can become teachers at schools to teach. So, you know, if you've done already a yoga training, you can learn this from me. The next batch, forthcoming batch, is starting on 15th of August. So you can all join and do this. Also, some of the you know, memories of this, usually the summer vacation, we used to have wonderful residential kids camp, where children used to come and stay with us, leaving their parents. The first day they used to cry because they have left their mothers and fathers. Last day they will cry because they don't want to leave we bhaiyas and didis and go back home. So they will always want to stay back. Some kids come repeatedly for camps. So these are the different activities, nature-based. So you see here all activities, and in the last day we make them do Matru Pitru Puja. So we teach them by making them worship parents, teach them the values of family system. And these are all the teachers of the recent batch who did complete at Adhyatma Yoga, this teacher's certificate. And I have been involved in training teachers, not only in Adhyatma Yoga, but in other organizations, teaching students, volunteers, in various ways in education system. I've been working on various aspects in spiritual aspect of yoga, therapeutic aspect of yoga, into various things at Adhyatma Yoga, and my team of Yoga Mitra, and we are all working in various things. Adhyatma Bharatam is a socio-spiritual cultural organization we have also. So all these we are working in various ways. But regard to education, giving this this yoga, kids yoga training, that where I'm involved more in schools, colleges, two organizations where I'm more involved. One is Disha Bharat, which is doing a very active work through Viveka Vikasa in schools and Disha in colleges. And for more than a decade, I have been actively involved in designing their yoga module, which has reached out to thousands of students in schools, colleges, even teachers as well. And similarly, Samvit is a research foundation from Rashtrothana Parishad, where also I'm involved in designing the curriculum for schools from 1 to 10 level. And today, more than 300 schools in Karnataka state has been adapting the syllabus they're all doing, and they're all following this wonderful curriculum. And now we have made a collaboration with the SVSR research also to validate these things scientifically. And I'm blessed to be a part of Indica Yoga also. And we have been having a lot of discussions ever since Indica Yoga started offering these programs. Me and my team from Adhyatma Yoga have been part of all NDOs of Indica Yoga. We just had the conference in the month of February. We had the international conference on praxis and philosophy of yoga at Bangalore, so where we were part of it. And now in the Global Festival of Yoga, and now I'm part of Indica Yoga as well. So therefore, we are working with Indica Yoga also to bring many such programs. And one such program, probably in a couple of days, Vinayji will announce, is we are planning to offer a certificate course in Bhakti Yoga. I have been brought up in the tradition of Bhakti Yoga, as in the introduction, Vinayji also said. So Bhakti Yoga is the science of emotion culture, which is very much required today for the current contemporary situation. So we have designed a curriculum based on Bhakti Yoga from the scriptures, like Srimad Bhagavatam, Narada Bhakti Sutra, the Upanishads and all, and based on the teachings and life and message of great masters. So we have such courses also. So all those will be announced through the platform of Indica Yoga. We will be doing, we also been contemplating on a course on spiritual wellness based on the life and message of spiritual masters, which also I would be offering through Indica Yoga. So many such things. So, you know, sky is the limit. And once you are having, you know, the passion to serve the society, God and gurus give you the guidance. And thanks to all my masters and all the co-travelers, the Sahai Yoga Yatrikas, with whose guidance, whose enthusiasm that I have been able to take all this ahead and give. Yeah, in the beginning, as rightly Vinayji shared, I have been doing the series of discussions with wonderful yoga stalwarts, you know, which is Kapi with Yogi. And sometimes I would say it is not Kapi, it is Kapi. Kapi is the mind. You know? Kapi in Sanskritam is monkey. So it is about me representing the monkey mind of common people talking with all yoga stalwarts. So we have a famous talk show, TV talk show called Coffee with Karan and all. So it's not coffee, we don't drink coffee. So it's Kapi, which means Kashaya and Atmiya Paraspara Charcha, Paraspara interaction with the yogi. So that is what we are having. And I was blessed to have various stalwarts whom many of you have seen in this platform also in Indica Yoga's Global Festival of Yoga. Like we had Dr. Ananda Bala Yogi, we had Guruji Dr. Nagendra in the first day. So all those, Dr. Naveen was also there. So with all those, you know, we have Dr. Ranganji, whom we have seen at Indica Yoga also. So all those people, so for 24, Aicha from Turkey, who was there in Indica Yoga's Global Festival. So all those more than 24 episodes we have completed. And now once a week, every Saturday, even today is Friday. Yeah, tomorrow night, 8 to 9, you can finish 7 to 8, the Indica Yoga session. And 8 o'clock, you will join with me in the Facebook Live. At the page Subhu Bhaiya in Facebook Live, you can watch me in the session of Kapi with a Yogi. It'll be a very nice interactive session as well. So thank you all so much for your patient listening. I think Achala had shared the details of our contact and all those. And there is also a link which is shared in case you are interested in joining this session. The teachers training the kids yoga. So you can click the link, that you can copy the link and click it and submit your inquiries, that will reach us. Thank you all so much. And I think I have exceeded 15 minutes of the time, which should have completed by 8:30, including the question answer session. But I saw that hardly there were any questions, you know. So I think a couple of questions, which if there is anything, I welcome Vinayji and Anuji to come back and share the questions to me. Thank you all so much again. You know, I don't have to thank Indica Yoga formally because I am part of Indica Yoga. So being part of the same organization, you know, it's like again, I don't have to go to that formality. But of course, thank you all the participants who are also part of our Indica Yoga family, the Global Yoga Parivar, who have been there. You know, I think today I have made a transformation. People in yoga talk of a lot of transformation. So this is at least mental transformation from 70 to 7. That's what many were saying. 40 to 4. So this, you know, I don't know, the inner transformation is all high. I think that's all that can happen only with the guru's guidance and by God's grace and by our sadhana, you know. And last, I would like, like to tell. So always retain this, this childhood memories of us, and to be this child, you know. So bring out this inner child. To be childish is not good. To be childlike is always good. And I think all of us should have that. Thank you so much. Namaste.
So we are wondering, what clap do we give you?
So we have a dynamic clap. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So we can all raise your hands like this. Stretch your hands. 1, 2, 1, 2. And now hands up. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Then here. 1, 2, 1, 2. And go back and clap. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Yes.
I said, Subbu Bhaiya, with you, the session can go on and on and on, and we'll get the whole variety of all the yoga practices in one package, which is Subbu Bhaiya.
Really, I had a, if you know, it would have been a physical session, not an online. So we'd have more team games where we could involve people and it'll be full of energy and you'll be running around making a lot of noise. So in online, and I cannot show you also a demo because I don't have any people nearby. Social distancing we are keeping. So in online, whatever is possible, little bit I showed. So it's like a tip of iceberg or something, as you say. So when you really, I think you can go to Adhyatma Yoga's YouTube page where some of the sessions we have shared some of the videos. You will see every time when we have a yoga day, the International Day of Yoga, I'll be in demand. Suddenly people will remember from schools, colleges, and from organizations to do this. They don't want to do, I can do asanas, I can do other things, or I can give lectures on yoga. No, we want your Kriya Yoga. And one small memory I would like to share. Last year, we had the Kumbh Mela, around, I think, the same, it was February during, the Magh Masa, we had the Kumbh Mela. And the Indian Yoga Association, IYA, had organized Yoga Kumbh as a part of Kumbh Mela. And we had Sri Sri Ravi Shankarji, Baba Ramdev, Swami Chidanand Muni of Rishikesh, all who had come. It was really a yoga sangama, and where I was also there with a team of my students, some of them who are here, I think Sumitrama and Shobha and everybody had joined with me, and we had made a yatra there. And day long, they had a lot of sessions. Imagine what more than Baba Ramdev's yoga session on the bank of the Trivedi Sangama, Sri Sri Sudarshan Kriya, and everything we had. Day long, packed, power packed, Ravi Tumludi and the secretary of the IYA from Ataflivi. Yeah?
Raviji.
Ravi and the Ataflivi, she's a good...
Kamlesh Barwar.
Kamlesh. So they had organized a whole lot of events. And then night, they had kept my event last. Okay. Actually, when I was myself so tired. And we had all these yoga stalwarts were sitting there. I thought, what will I go and do? And I didn't want to take much of their time. One tree song I did where all these, yoga stalwarts of the world who are there, and everybody they did, I don't know whether the video is available, I should search for it. So everybody they did, like children, they're already like children. Morning we should see Ramdev Baba and Ravi Shankar Chidanand Muni, they were like brothers in school, like children standing together on same stage, they will have fun there. And that night when I did this, everybody, Kavleshi, everybody they did this, and then now whole since morning Ramdev Baba says shuru karke night 8:30 tak, there were many yoga sessions. I did 1 5 minutes ka this Kriya Yoga, and then I took the whole day. Then everybody started taking selfies with me. So that is how that even in Yoga Kumbh now many people they keep remembering small things. These things can make a lot of difference. We are talking of stress management and all those. You don't have to do anything. Just smile. It doesn't cost anything. Open your, as a song I said, open your heart and then smile and then share your joyful memories and moments. And when doing yoga, you can involve fun and do. That is the great stress stress buster. Nothing else. Thank you so much.
I don't know if the clap exists or not, but listening to you, I said you're a star. So, and then a big bang.
Star. And give a star clap. Yeah. No, we can just create. I suggest creativity. Is important. All these people, they had such wonderful creativity. Krishna, it could be, all the yoga masters today we are seeing, right? So they all have that creativity. So I would not say it's a distortion. The same yoga techniques we are using, the same asanas, pranayama, everything. But the methodology is different. For children, understanding their age, and we are doing it. So I don't think there is anything. That's what Krishna has been, his pranks and all. That's why those stories are shared. So I would not look at it as a different version or a format of yoga. Same traditional yoga in a contemporary methodology for children. That's it.
Vinay, if I can just add one thing there.
Yes, please.
What struck me is that what you made us experience in the most joyful, natural manner has actually a very profound, the reason why we feel so good is because it has a very profound basis. And it struck me as you were speaking that when we had many participants saying that, you know, from 70 they turn 7 or from 50 to 5, I think what your joyful Kriya Yoga did for people is to allow all the samskaras that we collect with age. In a moment, it was like washed away.
Exactly.
So it is that washing away of the samskaras that create the layers of walls and barriers between who we are, that swabhavika ananda, that deep spontaneous ananda, which is the core of our being, that gets covered up with all our samskaras of growing up, likes, dislikes, the kleshas, fears, all of that forms this huge wall. And that starts creating this age in us, and you know, we get all very serious. And so this Kriya Yoga that you did, without talking about any great philosophy, spontaneously allowed those samskaras to be at least for a moment washed away. And I think there are many people who are going to be smiling throughout the rest of the day and the days to come, just with the memory of this wonderful samskara that you have left all our participants with. I mean, we're extremely grateful because it's also very evident that you're not doing this to, you know, to present a topic. You are deeply joyful in yourself. Like, you're also that inner child in you is very awake. And I think many of us who are witnessed, literally we had to witness the session, could, you know, touch that chord of delight, simple delight within ourselves. So I think that the call to this awakening the inner child is one of the best ways of allowing the weight, the baggage of our samskaras to get dissipated. The darkness being brought in, a little bit of light, the joyful light. So very beautiful. Thank you. I mean, really grateful.
Actually, that's why we call this summer camps we conduct for children in Vivekananda Kendra. It is called Samskar Varga. As rightly you said, the in Vivekananda Kendra, you know, where I had been a volunteer since my school days in Kanyakumari, where I learned some of these things for children, how we have to teach for children. Many things, I being a school student, and still I was a volunteer. That's where more some of these I learned. Of course, I added various dimensions of the actions and all those things and something. But the basis from Vivekananda Kendra, which is developed again at Svyasa, is also has its roots from Vivekananda Kendra Kanyakumari. So we call those camps as Samskar Varga. When you say that rightly, I think that's how the pioneers have named it as Samskar Varga.
So thank you very much, Subbu Bhaiya. I mean, we really don't know how to thank you enough for this session. What you give, I mean, this bringing out this joy, I think that is so important. And I'm reminded of Swami Chidananda Ji's words, who used to say, it need not be too serious on spiritual life.
Exactly.
In fact, there could be a lot of fun. And it's not like he used to say that it's not that you're in a hospital, that you need to have a long face if you're into the life of spirituality. And I think you brought it out in a beautiful experiential manner, like to be able to access that joy. We had been discussing about rasa swada in many sessions, and without even speaking about it, you just allowed us to experience it. So thank you very much. And I have copied the compliments of all our participants. The list is long; it runs to a few pages.
Okay.
So extremely grateful for what you offered. In fact, I would like to tell all our participants. See, we finally decided on doing a kids yoga with Subbuji, but initial plan was to do something with bhakti yoga. Had we done that, you would have experienced the same kind of bhakti and bhakti rasa. That is what the versatility of Subbuji is. Whether you take the bhakti marga or whether you take the krida marga, it's that involvement, that fun, that finally that rasa, that joy that he will allow us to access it. Then thank you so much, Subbuji, for that.
Thank you.
Just a technical note. Technical note is that it is important for us, and many of the participants already know, that at a brain level, what this does is that it stimulates four basic primary chemicals that drive positive emotions, and those are dopamine, oxytocin, serotonin, and endorphins. So our brains are now pumping with these very positive chemicals, and that will help us also feel this delight. But I think there is this challenge of, you know, people believing that it's first the chemicals and then the experience. But right. I think in yoga, it is completely reversed, where it is, you feel these emotions, you evoke the emotions through your mental pictures, through your, everything that you do. And as a consequence of that, these chemicals will be secreted and fill our system. So at the last, I think I wanted to also, not the last, I'll come back, but I just wanted to add that they say that a family that eats together and plays together bonds together. So I think from your session, what we will take back is that a game a day, or rather a Kriya Yoga a day, will keep Corona away.
Yes. Also, as I rightly said, you know, it's only the experience that not much any questions I see here. Only Dr. Jay Gupta has said, would it be possible to have video done for each song professionally with good quality, sound quality? Yes, that's my attempt now, actually.
We should take it up.
Because I have more of, as of now, the collections which I have like composed and which I have made on my own is around 30 plus songs I have on this list. And now the attempt is like many other existing songs which we have, like I used a bhajan to make this asana. Likewise, we have other poems which are there. If they're meaning, we have sometimes very rubbish poems in school days. We don't want to take all those. You know, I change a lot. For example, we had Johnny Johnny Yes Papa, like this. Instead, we say Krishna Krishna Yes Mama, eating mud No Mama, telling lie No Mama, open your mouth, ha ha ha, and Krishna shows the entire check.
Can you make us do this one? It's such a
one. Please. One. So yeah, Krishna Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Yes, mama. Eating mud? No, mama. Telling lie? No, mama. Open your mouth? Ha, ha, ha. And you see in the mouth, you know, the entire Jagat being there, and in the Jagat, you see the Bharatavarsha, Bharatakanda, you see India there in that, you see Uttar Pradesh, you see in that Mathura, in this, you see Vrindavan, in this, you see Gokula in Nandagav, in Nanda's house, in which you see Krishna's mother being there, Krishna's mouth open, in that mouth again, the entire Jagat, and then you see the Bharatavarsha, Bharatakanda, and then you see the Uttar Pradesh, and then Mathura, Vrindavan, Gokula, Nandagav, and then Nanda's house, and Yashoda, Krishna's mouth open again in that.
No, but we have to also include our Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam story. So we've got people from all the way from Singapore, and on this side we've got all the way people from America. We've got people all over. So you can see all those places.
All those. Krishna's mouth had whole entire Jagat. Yatkinje Jagatyam Jagat. That's what Krishna showed. So some of the poems, you know, we use those and make such actions, yoga actions, which I have made. And I have even used some of, we have very good, I have seen many good prayer songs. I studied in a Christian convent completely throughout my school days, and very good songs which I learned there, maybe biblical, but they convey a lot of good meaning. So I have incorporated yoga asanas as, techniques for that also, and we have made. So such things we can always do. So definitely, Dr. Jay Gupta, thank you for your suggestion. We would definitely make such good videos. And Vinay Kumarji have asked, how can we get trained? I already had shared detail, and yes, I think nothing more than that. We have questions. Yeah. Oh, who is there near to Vinayji? Yeah.
Yeah. So we have a representative for the kids yoga here. Wow. One more attendee.
Lift it up. Vinay, can you lift it up? We can't see.
I was actually wondering. Oh, they should have been doing this. I was thinking. Yeah.
Okay. So thank you, Subbuji, for that. And I would also like to mention once again, we are planning many such programs which will be rolled out shortly. We'll be announcing especially a course on Bhakti Yoga, which actually takes us through the various Bhakti saints, their lives, their messages, and their teachings, which Subbuji has very beautifully designed. So please stay tuned and follow us. Like, it will be announced on Indica Yoga platform and Adhyatma Yoga website. So we are collaborating on all these fronts. So I request you to all stay tuned and just continue what you got to experience a little bit of it. You had a taste of it today, but I promise you it will be much more rewarding than what you had today. So with these words, I thank Subbuji once again and all our participants. Okay,
thank you so much for both my friends, Anuji and Vinayji. It is a beautiful journey that we have been taking together all these years, and particularly after this global festival of yoga has started. So, you know, we are literally, she is in Kharagpur and Vinayji is at Rajaji Nagar. I'm at Jayanagar, but we're all in the same, you know, yoga jagat. We have created our own yoga jagat and we are in that world. So thank you for bringing this beautiful festival for all of us.
Thank you for being part of it. Yes, sir.
To mention that these courses will be certificate programs, right? Because yes. Many people on this have been asking for certificates on the festival, which we did not want to also do, because it was really doing it for the joy of learning, not always with an ulterior motive of doing something for something else. So the whole purpose of this celebration was really to do something for the freedom of just expanding oneself. But when we will do the courses, we understand that people need to also improve their professional qualifications and all. So those would be certified programs. So please join those and enhance your own professional and personal skills through those various programs. And Indica Yoga is the Vedic idea came to my mind. It's Yatra Vishwam Bhavatyekanidam.
Yekanidam.
So the whole world becomes like one nest. So this platform is really not in competition with any others. And we cannot emphasize that enough. It is really not in competition. It is in collaboration that we will be able to allow this, allow the legacy that we have inherited as a human race. Again, this knowledge that we have got is not an Indian monopoly. The sages belong to this land, but as we have seen on our platform, there are sages in many lands. But this land has documented and researched, investigated this as a priority of its civilization. So we'd like to become a nest that will welcome authentic teachings. The purpose is not commercialization. The purpose is really to involve as much of authentic thought and practice so that we can learn and bring light as a collectivity in the world. So the attitude also is like what we had Stephen Covey, who's coined these terms of, you know, abundance mentality and scarcity mentality. The objective of this is abundance mentality. There is enough for everyone out there. Let us not be possessive and small and, you know, petty in the wealth that we have for ourselves. And let's share it so that all of us can collectively have integral well-being in our lives.
Very nice, Anuji. I just want to add something. I'm seeing here some of the very senior yoga teachers of the whole yoga fraternity, I would say. Pankaja Seshadriyaka is here. She is a very prominent yoga teacher at Bangalore. Maybe for the past 40 years that she has been teaching yoga at Bangalore. I've seen her. She says, you know, Pankajaka, good luck. Wish you, wishing you good luck. Vishwabandhu Yogi, Pankaja Seshadri, who is a you know, well-known name in South Bangalore for yoga. I think more than 40 years that she has been teaching in Devagiri temple in Bangalore and various places in South Bangalore. Thank you, Pankajaka, for joining and giving your blessings. I also, in the beginning, saw Raghuramji, who was also following with us. So, thank Guruji Raghuramji also. And various other very senior people, I'm seeing them on the attendees who are attending this. So, thank you all so much for joining us.
So, we'll quickly make the announcements for the day and then get back to you. For, in fact, you have given us enough to cherish throughout the day. So if there's one more additional thing that you'd like to share as a message or a tip,
messages, Adi Narayanan and Smriti's session, Mauna.
So Ramprasadji, can I request you to kindly show us the poster for the evening? So this evening we have a practice session once again, practice session on prana and pranayama. An exploration of the vital force, The session will be led by Madeline Modha Evans, who is a yoga teacher based out of UK and Switzerland. And she has been into the path of Vedanta, trained under the guidance of Swami Dayananda Saraswati Ji, Swamini Atma Prakashananda Ji, and inspired by the Vedantic vision, she has been involved in the teaching of yoga, and she will be focusing on pranayama this evening. So do stay with us, and tomorrow morning, I would really like to mention it once again. You heard so much about Swami Vivekananda in this session, and it has come a few places earlier also. So we have an exclusive session dedicated to the life and message of Swami Vivekananda. What does it mean to be a yogi? In fact, the quotation is taken from Bhagavad Gita, Tasmad Yogi Bhava. Therefore, be a yogi, life and message of Swami Vivekananda. That will be a session tomorrow morning by Gokul Muthu Narayan Swamiji, who is one of the well-known scholars on Vivekananda. And tomorrow evening, again, a very interesting session on food is auspicious. In fact, that will also be an experiential session where one of the best or the top chef of India, in fact, one of the known chef of the entire world chef community, Chef Manjit Singh Gill, will be with us presenting on a topic called Food is Auspicious. So games can be yoga, food can be yoga, everything can be yoga. This is all the approach that we have taken at Indica Yoga. So with this, I now come back to Subbuji. You have already shared the contact details. I think one of the best ways is to follow Subbuji's work is on his Facebook page and also on his website. Yes. And now, what is that you would like to share at the end?
I think just as we brought out the inner child in us, so don't again get the child to be lost in the world today, what we are having. Children are, you know, very fragile, that they get usually, you know, in big festivals, when crowd, they get lost. So today we have a big crowd of all our busy schedule life, and all the things that we are having. So let us not get this child whom we have found out today from us, the inner child. Let's not make this child get lost again. So keep the child, the inner child, always awake, always in jagrat, in awakefulness. And so whenever, you know, you are in kind of a stressful situation, so go back and experience that inner child. You know, in Kannada, we have beautiful Mankutimana Kagha, where DVG, the great poet, he says, you know, you compartmentalize your mind into two. So the external compartment, being the adult, get involved into all serious work of your household, family, activities, everything that you do. But keep this inner child within you. So go back to that inner child and, you know, have that, refreshment, have that, you know, recollections of the beautiful memories. So enjoy the childhoodness, not of the old memories. In the present, being a child, and still you can, you know, be more matured adult as well. So that balance of the inner child and external adult, that is what's more important. And yoga is the right way to give us this balance. And so that's all what today we experienced. And as rightly Anuji said, the samskaras. So let us keep this all in alertfulness and let the child in us always enjoy the daily life at the presence. Thank you.
Thank you. That's a beautiful note to conclude this session. There is a child in all of us. Don't allow it to get lost in the crowd. Thank you very much.
Namaste. Dhanyavaad.
And thanks to all our participants. Namaste.